persons gathered on Friday night at the junction of Faubus Road and Central American Boulevard, where police had cordoned off the street from traffic. Inside a Mazda car on the right-hand side of the boulevard, its driver, 35-year-old Vern Magdaleno, better known as Bird, lay dead after a gunman reportedly fired a single shot to the side of his head. He had just arrived at Taito Fried Chicken, where his common-law wife alighted the vehicle to go and purchase food, when the report of a single blast shattered the ambience.
There was a crowd of people rushing, you know, at the moment. I was distracted for a little while, and next thing I know, I heard, pow. And I look outside quickly, and I saw this person, you know, riding off, and next thing I knew, somebody started crying, which I didn't know that was his spouse, and she was at the moment buying a fried chicken, and I believe I saw that she ran to the vehicle, check on him, and run back into the crowd of people that was in front of the shop. And after that, I was terrified at the moment, and I run to back of the shop and in another part, and I call 911.
The gunman would ride off on bicycle and escape from police, who arrived shortly after the incident occurred. It is believed that a surveillance camera in the area may have caught the incident on tape.
Police visited an area on at the corner of Faubus Road and Central American Boulevard, where they saw the lifeless body of Vern Magdaleno, 35 years. Belizean of Faubus Road extension address, with a single gunshot wound to the left side of the head. He was in a seated position inside his car. Thereafter, he was transported to the KHMH, where he was pronounced dead on arrival. Police recovered one expended 9mm shell from the scene. Several persons were at that establishment purchasing chicken at the time, and we have conducted several interviews and recorded several statements, but so far we have not been able to lay any charges on anyone regarding this shooting.
Do you know who is the suspect?
We are looking for persons of interest at this time, but again, we have not been able to charge anyone for that murder.
Was there any surveillance video that was retrieved captured the incident that happened?
Well, we have our officers still working on that. Today is Monday, and they are reviewing the entire area to see if the cameras captured anything. But so far, we have not gotten any at this time.
But who would want Magdaleno dead? Police say that they have yet to ascertain the motive for the latest homicide in the city. His family also is clueless as to who could have wanted their youngest brother dead and why.
My sister called and said that she called and told me that they just shot her brother. She was screaming and crying. And so I left the event, came down immediately on my motorbike. And when I got on the Faubus Road, he was still inside the car. And the police would not allow me to go and see his body because it's a crime scene. Eventually, they take him out of the car, put him in the pickup truck, and then they carried him off to the morgue. And so I followed the police truck to the morgue, and that's when I saw him lifeless in the back of the truck with a gunshot wound to the air, straight in the air, and the bullet lodging the head, I would believe. So, killing him on the spot, no?
We have no motive for that. Like I said before, he had only been charged for a burglary, as far as we know, and it's not known to associate with any persons of questionable character.
He didn't make any complaint as to say that he was being threatened or somebody's after him or anything to the sort. As a matter of fact, there was no physical threat because he moved around freely. He goes to the shop, he goes to the ATM to buy, he dropped his children to school, so if there was a threat, then he would be more cautious in the way he moved, but there was no threat. And so, with that, then, we are still puzzled as to why he was killed and for what reason.
Magdaleno leaves behind his common-law wife and their three children. Dwayne Moody for News.